Remember how exciting it was to install that little airlift airbag compressor in such a dry and secure location, away from all sources of water? Well...
So there is no gasket on this motor end cap. So if any moisture gets close to it, even in a high spot, which is pretty well protected, this is what happens. That's the end of that.
So what do? You just buy another compressor and replace the one that broke, and it lasts as long as it lasts? Or if you're one of those people who has an onboard air system, there's a new option for you. Just replace the compressor with a solenoid. This is a 12-volt solenoid, air solenoid. It's sold by none other than Airlift, which makes sense in a way. But instead of supplying the air from the compressor, you're going to take the air from your onboard air compressor system and have it go into here. The solenoid will open when the compressor would have otherwise gotten a normal command to run. Solenoid opens, lets the air through, and off she goes. One of the concerns with plumbing that manifold directly into a 150 psi 2-gallon air tank is that the manifold will get hit with a lot of air at a high pressure all at once. So what we want to do is to decrease that volume of air. It's not so much the PSI that's the problem, it's the volume of air. What we can do is put a smaller hose in the loop going before the manifold and decrease the amount of air that can actually pass through that hose. So this is a picture of the size of the air line in a 1/4-inch line and a 3/16 line. You can see the orifice is actually much smaller that fits inside a 3/16 line. The amount of air that'll pass through a 3/16 hose is actually 1/4 of the amount of air that'll pass through a 1/4-inch line. So I'll take off the air fitting that is on the manifold air dryer right there. This is the air filter that runs in front of the airlift manifold. And so I can just put that one in place of the other. I'm going to go ahead and put the fitting, the smaller 3/16 fitting, into this side of the solenoid. The savvy viewers will notice that this is actually a push-to-connect fitting, which I generally hate because they leak. This fitting is actually a DOT brake line approved, and so if you're going to do push-to-connects, get one that is a good one, and this is one of those. It will not leak. Well, now we're ready to take this mess and go find a place to put it on the truck again. Okay, I found a really great spot in front of the rear tire and up inside in between the bed walls. Here we go. That is the positive and the negative to the manifold. There is the 3/16 line. Let's see that all the way down. There. There's the other side. Now on to tapping into the existing air system. And here I'm just going to add another T to the end of the compressor, disconnecting the original line that goes back to the bumper. I'm going to put a T on there so we can connect in both the new air solenoid and restore the connection to the back bumper for the air coupler. We'll make a new connection here. That goes back to the coupler on the bumper. There we go. There we go. Holy mackerel, that was hard. Now I'm going to fish the hose over from the air tank to the air solenoid. Found a nice little chase in the cross member of the frame. So join me at another part of the truck, under the truck here. This solenoid will be in place of the compressor. So when the manifold commands the compressor to run, it will open up this solenoid, the valve, and let air in from the tank, and it will go past through the solenoid up to the dryer
on the manifold, and then ultimately out. The last thing is to connect the lines to the left and right airbags, and we'll see if this thing works.
And that is why we hate push to connects. Okay, Jackson, we're gonna see how long it takes to fill up the airbags. So you have to push this button twice, and then that button. Are you ready?
Yes.
Get set, go. Quick, good job.
Yes.
Now we're timing it. We're gonna see how long. Look at the rate that thing fills. The airbags are going awfully fast. And the compressor on the onboard air compressor is taking off. There it is, 15 seconds. That's crazy. Jackson, that was fast.
13 seconds.
That was as fast as your soccer shoes. I've been running this for a little over a month now, and I've trailered with it twice, and it works like a charm. So I thought it might be fun to just show you some extra times. That last test was for 5 PSI up to 85 PSI, but take a look at like going to 45 and 65. I'll just give you those numbers. Let's take them from 5 PSI to 45 PSI. Oops, here we go. That's how long. And no overshooting, because we've decreased the volume of air that's going to that manifold. What if we want to go to 65 PSI? There we go. And that used up more than 2 gallons of air, so it turned on the compressors. Now, drop in pressure is just exactly the same as it would be for compressor or solenoid. It's just the amount of time that the manifold allows the air to escape. So this is no change. It will deflate at the same rate. So that is a 100% good option for those who have onboard air and want to run their wireless air system with it. Just follow those rules, and it's working for me.